Assalamu alaikum, dear viewers. I am Dr. Muhammad Atikur Rahman, Assistant Professor, Anatomy Department, Ad-Din Akij Medical College, Khulna. Today, I will discuss about suprarenal gland. Suprarenal glands or adrenal glands are a pair of important endocrine gland situated retroperitoneally in the posterior abdominal wall on each side of the vertebral column and surmount on the upper end of the corresponding kidney. Suprarenal gland consists of outer cortex and inner medulla. These two zones are different from each other in phylogenetically, structurally, functionally, and developmentally. But in anatomically, we considered these two zones as single gland. Capsule of the suprarenal gland. Each suprarenal gland is covered by inner true capsule and outer false capsule. True capsule is derived from the condensation of the fibrous stroma of the gland. False capsule is derived from renal fascia. The two layers of renal fascia fuse at the upper end of the kidney, then resplit to enclose the suprarenal gland in a separate compartment. At the upper end of the suprarenal gland, these two layers fuse and reflected to the diaphragm as the suspensory ligament of the suprarenal gland. Now, size of the suprarenal gland. The average measurement of the suprarenal gland is as follows. Height is 50 mm, breadth is 30 mm, thickness is 10 mm, and weight is 5 grams. Now, shape and presenting part of suprarenal gland. Right suprarenal gland is triangular or pyramidal in shape and has apex, base, two borders, medial and lateral, and two surfaces, anterior and posterior. Left suprarenal gland is semilunar in shape and has two ends, upper and lower, two borders, medial and lateral borders, and two surfaces, anterior and posterior surface. Hilum of the suprarenal gland. The hilum of the suprarenal glands provides emergence of the suprarenal vein. Now, position of the hilum. In case of right suprarenal gland, it is near the upper end. In case of left suprarenal gland, it is near the lower end of the gland. Now, accessory suprarenal glands. Sometimes cortical tissues are found in the following sites. Number one, around the main suprarenal gland. Number two, within the broad ligament of uterus. Number three, within the spermatic cord of testes. Number four, within the mesenteries of the gut. Now, structure of the suprarenal gland. Each gland consists of outer cortex and inner medulla. The medulla forms 1/10 of the entire gland and is surrounded by the cortex except at the hilum. Now, cortex of the suprarenal gland. The cells of the cortex are arranged in three zones. From outside to inside, they are zona glomerulosa, zona fasciculata, and zona reticularis. These zones occupy 15%, 65%, and 7% respectively of the total volume of the suprarenal gland. Now, zona glomerulosa. This zone consists of small polyhedral cells. These cells are arranged in arch column. These zones secretes mineralocorticoids, which regulate sodium and potassium balance of the body. The most active principle is known as aldosterone, which helps absorption of sodium ion from the distal convoluted tubules of nephrons in exchange of excretion of potassium or hydrogen ion in the tubular lumen. The activity of this zone are mostly regulated by renin-angiotensin mechanism. Now, zona fasciculata. It is the thickest zone and consists of polyhedral cells, which are arranged in straight cords, separated by straight capillaries and sinusoid. This zone secretes glucocorticoids, which regulate carbohydrate and protein metabolism of the body. The most active principle of this zone is known as cortisol, which helps conversion of proteins to carbohydrates. Zona reticularis, it is the innermost layer hair cells arrange in irregular cords. These zones secretes glucocorticoids and sex hormones like androgen or estrogen. This sex hormone regulates secondary sex characters in conjunction with the gonads. Now, medulla of the suprarenal gland. Medulla consists of chromaffin cell, some ganglion cells, capillaries and sinusoids. The chromaffin cell secretes epinephrine and norepinephrine during emergency, and these catecholamines stimulate sympathetic nerve endings. Artery supply of the suprarenal gland. Each gland is supplied by the following arteries. Number 1, superior suprarenal artery, which is a branch of inferior phrenic artery. Number 2, middle suprarenal artery, it is a branch of abdominal aorta. And number 3, inferior suprarenal artery, a branch of renal artery. The arteries form a plexus beneath the capsule. From this plexus, straight vessels pass through the cortex and end in the medullary sinusoids, either directly or via cortical sinusoids. The vessels which communicate cortical and medullary sinusoids are known as suprarenal portal system. Such portal vessels convey an enzyme known as phenylethanolamine N-methyltransferase from cortex to medulla for conversion of norepinephrine into epinephrine by methylation. Venous drainage of suprarenal gland. The venules start from the medullary sinusoids and unite to form a single suprarenal vein, which appears through the hilum of the gland. Right suprarenal vein drains into inferior vena cava and left vein drains into the left renal vein. Now, lymphatic drainage. Lymphatic drains into the lateral aortic lymph node. Nerve supply of the suprarenal gland. The medulla is supplied by the sympathetic nerve from the celiac plexus, conveying fibers from the thoracic 8 to lumbar 1 segments of spinal cord. These fibers make synaptic connection with the chromaffin cells of the medulla, which acts as postganglionic neuron. The activity of the cortex are mostly controlled by adrenocorticotropic hormone, which is secreted by anterior pituitary gland. Now, development of suprarenal gland. The cortex develops from the mesoderm of coelomic epithelium, and medulla develops from the neural crest cells. Now, applied anatomy. Deficiency of mineralocorticoids result in Addison's disease, which is characterized by increased skin pigmentation, muscular weakness, hypotension, and weight loss. Adrenal hyperplasia with excessive mineralocorticoid secretion results in Kohn's syndrome, which is characterized by hypertension and hypokalemia. Again, adrenal hyperplasia with excessive secretion of glucocorticoids leads to Cushing syndrome. It is manifested by truncal obesity, hypertension, and hirsutism in females. Excessive secretion of adrenal androgen from the zona reticularis produces adrenogenital syndrome, which results in masculinization of females and precocious puberty in males. Pheochromocytoma is a tumor of the medulla. It causes hypertension due to secretion of a large amount of catecholamines. This is all for today. Hope you will get some idea about suprarenal gland. Thank you.